out to a security guard charged in the death of a patron. News 4's Mandy Gaither has been on this story all day. She joins us live and local at the Anderson County Detention Center tonight. Mandy, the guard turned himself in today, right?
It was around noontime that he turned himself in here. He's now awaiting a bond hearing, which is expected in the morning.
In this exclusive video, Joey Ryan Johnson Jr. is turning himself in at the Anderson County Detention Center Thursday, charged with voluntary manslaughter and assault of a high and aggravated nature.
Is there anything y'all want to say at this point?
It's the same day India Lomax was laid to rest. Johnson told investigators he shot the 21-year-old mother after he says she drove a truck aimed at him while leaving Marvon's nightclub on the 28 bypass Saturday. Deputies say Johnson is a security guard hired to protect the parking lot of the club. Lomax's passenger, Willis Reginald Donald, was also shot in the arm.
We are definitely going to be asking for a not guilty on this because he is not guilty.
Johnson's attorney, Drew Ann White, says her client acted in self-defense despite an autopsy that revealed Lomax died after being shot in the back.
In this state, one is allowed to keep shooting until the threat is over. Not just the threat to yourself, but the threat to others as well.
Deputies say there was a report of weapons being involved during a dispute that Johnson was breaking up before the shooting happened, but at this point they're still investigating whether the victims were armed. Anderson County Sheriff John Skipper says right now multiple bullets found at the scene all came from Johnson's gun.
We have gotten several statements from folks, and that's what brought us to this conclusion today.
Investigators are hoping more witnesses will come forward. In the meantime, Johnson's attorney says they plan to fight the charges.
And the county's investigation was coordinated with SLED because SLED oversees all security companies. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in Anderson County.